because for the number of times no one is Excuse me, just let's allow the media to allow the media to
thank you very much. As we indicated in our earlier press briefing, we said we are going to report Nakachinda as a law-abiding political party.
Yes.
We respect the law and we've reported Nakachinda for contempt and defamation of the president, also hate speech against the head of state.
Yes.
As youths, we monitor the action from the police.
Yes.
And we expect the police to move in and arrest Nakachinda.
Yeah, yeah.
Because he's a bad seat. Nakachinda is a criminal.
Uh-huh.
What he was perpetrating yesterday at the High Court is total criminality.
Yes.
And we are not going to allow him to continue the same criminality. As we are law-abiding citizens, and we want the peace which UPND party, which His Excellency the President Hakainde Hichilema has created, to continue, not the confusion which PF has started through Nakachinda. And I want to repeat that these violence, these schemes are being funded by Edgar Lungu, and we want to urge Lungu to retire from active politics. His work has created a scheme to divert the attention of His Excellency the President from doing the developmental program which he has set for this country and start thinking about lip-laps like Nakachinda and his team. We are not going to tolerate them.
Yes.
And I want to repeat that all the youths this time around, this time, they should go out and start hunting for Nakachinda. And at all costs, we are going to help the police in hunting for Nakachinda and the other PF criminals who their aim is to destabilize the peace the country is now enjoying. The fresh air which the president has brought in our country, they want to contaminate it. We are not going to allow it. So I want to thank all the youths and all the media houses who came to cover as we are reporting Nakachinda to police. We urge him to turn it down, and we are not going to leave him bring chaos in our country in the name of human rights, in the name of freedom of expression. He's abusing his freedom of expression, and we're not going to allow his nonsense.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much, guys. Today, we have officially reported Raphael Nakachinda of PF for defamation of the president. It is we are very concerned over the allegations that Nakachinda made against the president, the head of state of the Republic of Zambia, His Excellency Hakainde Hichilema. Raphael Nakachinda said the president has been meeting the judges in tight corner meetings where is inciting, or rather persuading the judges to look against all the minister, all the members of parliament that were sent out of parliament. Because of this, we are very much concerned, and we are not happy, and we feel that Raphael Nakachinda is inciting the nation, is inciting the youths to rise against the president of the Republic of Zambia with his allegations. So we reported him for defamation of the president so that he can be arrested within 48 hours. Within 48 hours, Raphael Nakachinda should be arrested so that he can prove all the allegations he raised against the Republican president. Yes. Thank you very much.
We want to recognize the Secretary General and the tourists from the RPP and the NDC youth leadership and party leadership. We want to thank you, dear colleagues, for coming through.
You're welcome.
For this very important and disappointing moment where a named citizen, very soon the police will review his identity. He has not only defamed the president, but he has also made it possible for people to lose the confidence that which they have in the judiciary and the governance systems, which includes the executive, which is the Zambia police, and the presidency. So we want to say the Zambia police, we are grateful And we do not want to allow fools to continue speaking foolishness, because even if stupidity continuously spoken in the eyes of people, it becomes almost partial truth. So in order for us to remove that notion, we want to bring about civility in this country. It is indeed that we met Raphael Nakachinda on the 10th of December with my two other colleagues. One other colleague is not around here. And he did mention that he had intentions of making this government ungovernable. And we have now proved that he was not joking. And since he was not joking, we have also taken it that we don't want to go personal, to allow the police to do a very thorough investigation. And we don't want to do a mumbo-jumbo kind of arrangement. We want them to do a thorough investigation using other governance wings of this Republic of Zambia to make sure that we come out with the correct results. And we are not overzealous citizens, as you can see. We are youths. We have united for the purpose of bringing dignity. The president must be addressing a lot of issues, among them youth unemployment. And then we don't want the president to be defending himself over issues that which are petty as this one. So that alone will allow the police to work. We will skid around and make sure that we will do what we are supposed to do to empower ourselves and make this republic a viable destination for the investors and for everybody of us. We thank you, dear Commissioner.
Just a quick one, just an addition of what has transpired. The youths who have arrived, the youths of the UPND Alliance. You see, as we are committed to our campaign commitment, we are not refraining Honorable Raphael Nakachinda to express himself as an opposition leader. But we want to help our dear colleague that as he's zooming, he should bring that binoculars to the police so that the police would help him try and zoom and see what he's seeing. Maybe the Zambian people are not seeing what he's seeing. So we're trying to help him out so that he brings that binoculars here. Secondly, we want to set a trend that politicians should not just get excited and issue statements that are baseless, that are not have facts, and they go scot-free because of freedom of expression. You have to know that freedom of expression comes with responsibility, that when you issue certain things, you have to have facts on the ground for you to prove your allegations. And secondly, want to challenge the police. May wish to know that we want to be as consistent as we could. You know, they remember the gassing part. The gassing part, we have careless talk around it, and we lost members as a public. We lost over that. So we want those who from the PF who said that they know the gassers should report themselves, or the police should follow them. Those are the things that we are fighting. It's just facts as we criticize the government. Thank you.